In a place like Mombasa, for example, where Wiper already has two candidates, ODM has one for the position of governor, and Jubilee has one. If at all these different candidates within the opposition go it separately, aren't they just splitting the opposition's vote? And that could just play into the hands of Jubilee, because Jubilee has only one candidate.
Yeah, I think that it's to our advantage, actually, at the end of that. And we knew from the onset, we knew from the onset that the magnet that is holding NASA as a coalition is very weak. You cannot tell me that today NASA will want to lead this country when one, they have not even agreed on the presidential candidate. And I think, assuming that one, now this is even the elephant in the house, is the party primaries. Looking at, for instance, Mombasa, we have Senator Hassan Omar, and we have Awiti, and we have Joho, and we have one candidate for Jubilee.
Yes.
And it is very clear, and you can take this to the bank, that by end of April, by end of August, the governor of Mombasa will be a Jubilee member.
Because surely Joho enjoyed votes when he was elected from even Wiper supporters.
And by the way, before even we go to that, you remember every principal in NASA will still want to get many politicians under their party. There was no way Kalonzo Musyoka, who feels like he's more senior in the NASA, would have allowed a joint primaries to be done, because that would mean that there's a likelihood that the number of members of parliament, members of county assembly, governors and the senators of Wiper will decrease. But more fundamentally is what Raila said, and I think that is where I agree with Raila. When Raila spoke yesterday, he said that what is leading this conversation is selfish interest. Mm-hmm. And he came out at a yesterday, I agree with him, that we need to look at, to have a bigger picture. And the bigger picture for him is that let us make an effort of ensuring that we ignore these small issues and come up as a coalition. But it is working for us as Jubilee.
Yes. Even as we continue this conversation, and before I give Kimosop an opportunity, my colleagues Willis Waburu and Joy Muthengi are all the way in Siaya. I do understand we'll be linking up with them in a short while. Just remember that we'll be heading to Siaya in a short while to link up with Willis Waburu and Joy Muthengi. We continue with this conversation here with Bwana Vincent Kimosop. Breakfast served in Siaya. Willis Waburu has taken Joy Muthengi all the way to Siaya.
Do we need an objective analysis of that? We don't know what to analyze.
And she said yes to going all the way to Siaya.
That's great.
And we've seen the beautiful sun just coming out in Siaya. We'll be linking up with them in a short while. Wow, are they ready? Okay, I do understand that the pictures are ready, the signal is there already, and we have a few more minutes before we actually head out to Siaya, a minute or so, and probably because they'll be there at the VIP hotel, an opportunity for Bwana Vincent Kimosop before we go for a break.
Okay, I think if you look at the NASA narrative, Every time the opposition unites against the incumbent, the incumbent should actually lose sleep, because a united opposition sends a message of one that of an alternative a narrative for the people. So the unity of NASA is replicated. For example, the history favors it in the sense that one, in 2002, when the opposition united against the jihad joint primaries, they sent a message of that they are unorganized, they actually are behaving like the alternative government. So I think for me, if I was the strategic direction NASA should take, if they would want to replace Jubilee, is a direction of unity. Because truly, if I believe that the government that is in power is not addressing the issues as they are, and we are four or five political parties that believe the same thing, irrespective of who becomes a member of parliament, the bigger narrative is what you should be pursuing. 2002 it happened and they went on board. They won. So what is happening, if they send a signal and a message of disunity at this point, then one of the strategies Jubilee needs to do is just to invest in the, for example, one of the political parties in NASA, give them resources, and what is going to happen, and even possibly consider one of them running all the way with the possibility mm-hmm. of a post-coalition agreement. So
yes.
such kind of headlines is not very good, for example, for the journey that NASA. Remember, Fred, InfoTrack, Ipsos, together with Strategic, the three pollsters, if we had to believe their narrative, this is what they agreed in their last result, in their opinion polls they released less than 2 weeks ago. And they were commissioned actually by citizens. Remember it being
yes.
part of the analysis. 60% of Kenyans are saying that their country is not headed in the right direction.
Mm-hmm.
Now, 50% of them, which actually questions the some of you don't see the connection, say that Jubilee should be given a chance. Now, if you were sitting in the war room of the opposition, you can see already the context has been prepared. Only 60% of the country are saying the country is not headed in the direction, in the right direction. What happens? You give an opportunity to for an alternative to be presented.
Mm.
So if, when they are again saying 50%, that Jubilee needs
yes.
still to begin. So Kaluma.
And before Kaluma speaks,
yes.
We need to take a break. But it appears like in the case of Mombasa now that the opposition there, which is now Jubilee. In the case of Mombasa, the Jubilee and the opposition, yes,
yeah,
and NASA should
and
be
Nairobi.
The incumbent.
Mm.
So the incumbent is split, but the opposition is united, in as far as Mombasa is concerned.
Mm.
Let's now take a break. Pa Breakfast will be back shortly.